There are basically two types of project. First type is research-based project that you have to do some specific task and a specific problem to work on and do some practical thing over it and do some specific problem solving. Means there is a problem and issue like this, whether it's novel or not novel, it's fine. And then you have to do some solution that this is solution that we are doing or we are proposing or this is existing solution and you have to write the that research project properly. So this is first type of project that you are doing. Second type of project would be some industrial project, means some technical, highly technical project. So this second highly technical or industrial project, you do something exhaustive, means do too many things. There are four or five things or two, three things. If you are not able to do first type of research project, then you do second type of technical project where you can do multiple things and then you write about that multiple things in the write-up report and that will be showing that you have actually did something valuable to the project. So this is the second way, doing something large, exhaustive project and doing some more feature and then writing it up and presenting it as a technical project. Regarding the team members work, so some of the team members should be like software developer, they develop something, and some of the team member would be like software tester, they execute the development and they test whether that developing thing is working properly or not. And some of the team member would do some write-up and presentation thing and literature survey. So these are the tasks that you can divide among the teammates. First, literature survey, second, software development, third, software testing, and fourth, like executing and just doing write-up things.
Yes, so we have already divided our team into different groups that they are doing different things. As we have six members, so we have quite some we have divided them into two, two, and one, one each for different tasks. And furthermore, every task has been divided into subtasks that we are following up with a timeline on a particular board that we have shared with each one of us. So every task has a deadline that and a person assigned to it, and they have to complete it by that particular time.
Okay, good.
Hello. So the in general instruction for the project and the presentation and report part that you all have to do is like the report and presentation should only contain about the work that you have done, not describing too much detail about the existing technology, existing keywords or existing platform that you had used. If somebody want to study that thing, they can go on the internet and study about that thing. You just give that this part you have used means Google App Engine you have used, and these are the service of Google App Engine that you had used. You had used Firebase. You don't need to describe about Firebase. You just say that these are the things that we have done with the Firebase and Google App Engine. That's it. Next, you just have to present what you have done, and you have to write that also in the report, what your group have done, not about the technology or the existing things. Existing things are already available. You just write the keyword name and then start describing what your group had done. Next instruction is like there could be many diagrams possible in the project, so you must try and think about what diagram should best fit for your project presentation. For example, there are architecture diagrams, model diagrams. Means your work, the work that your project have been done and your group have done, you just need to describe that thing. And you have to describe like models that you have done with the diagram. Model, like architecture, use case, there are many kind of diagram. You think by yourself what kind of diagram fits best with your project. There are sequential diagram, data flow diagram, or many control flow diagram. Next, every project must contain some diagram. At least one diagram there should be. I am expecting from each report, and from each presentation. Don't try to put too many diagrams. That is also not good. Only the important diagrams that are very important, which is actually describing your project and presentation. And don't describe about the diagrams and all these things which were being done by some other researcher or some other internet available content. It's not good. What you have done, you just describe that. And if you required to present some diagram or some work of other, you just give a citation and reference to that link or some research paper or some content, that these are the thing that we had referred and it's available thing, we didn't draw on it. The diagram that you draw, even if you see some diagram, existing diagram, but you still you draw by yourself, it's you can say that it's your diagram and you just modify that significantly, then it will be your diagram. So this is the way you draw diagrams. Next instruction is like, there are two kind of projects that are possible. First is application based project, like you had already seen many projects that you have already done in many courses. So most of them were application based projects. So they are like demonstration, they are like having development, code development, some use case development, and having some technical things out of it. And there is second kind of project, which is research based project. In research based project, you target one specific problem, that these two, three issues are there and problems are there, which are related to this domain, and you try to solve it in this way. So there are one way, second way that you propose, third way. So you need to propose some way, one way, at least one way, or if you have two ways, then two ways. So these are the two kind of project, application based project and research based project. So we'll come to the first project, application based project. So I have one instruction for application based project. Like application based project is something like having demo type of thing. What is demo type of thing? So it's demo means some demonstration that you will give in the end. Demo, how you will demonstrate? By executing the content. And how you are going to demonstrate the content, you have some developed tool. For example, this automated web service change management tool that I had developed and presented, and this is the kind of use case or some content that was developed, that architecture of this tool. So you need to draw architecture like this, that these are the modules. Then you have some this kind of diagram which will describe the activities of your tool. And this is the application based project that I will describe this tool in detail to all of you, that how this works, and then you have to think that how your project could be improved in this way. So experiments, that case studies that I did, and this is final one architecture. So this is first kind of project. So you must need to demonstrate this tool, and this is one first kind of project. And there's another kind of project, the same thing, that the same tool have a research problem, that you need to describe the introduction, what is the basic thing that you are dealing with, then the problem that you are dealing with, and then next your approach to solve it. How did you solve it? Like I created slicing of web service code for solving subset service analysis, different kind of category of analysis I proposed. So this is how your work should be, and the different kind of services could be accessed, and then demonstrating the example, like service one, service two has been having different service, combined service, and this reduced service. So this is how you describe the example. Then case study, experiment that your project should contain. And next, the case study and parameters that your project should contain, and this the application that you work with. Next, conclude your work and give some future work. So this is how you describe the proposed research-based problem solution work. This is second kind of project that we are dealing with. Next, we are basically discussing about experiment. So both kind of project should have experiment that describes the example that these are the application that you have done, this project that you have deal. So these are the web services that was the input, and describe about the experiment. In both the cases, you need to, both the kind of project, you need to describe the experiment that, like, these are the web services that was being used, and then what are the experimentation result and how it has been described. So you think by yourself that how you are going to describe the result. Every project should contain the experiment and description of these experiment. And next, this must have input. This experiment means what? Input, execution, and multiple output, or the multiple input, having multiple environmental condition, and then multiple output can be generated. So these are the things that you do with the experiment: multiple input, multiple execution environment, multiple output. So these are the three things that vary in the experiment, and that experiment depends on the project to project. Every project have a different kind of experimental analysis. Next, I have described all these two papers. So first, in one lecture, I will describe the whole project in detail, so that, and this project will also cover some part of your coursework. So these two things are like, I will describe the demo-based project, application-based project, and this for the research-based project. So both the research project that I did, both the demo and the research project that I did, belongs to the same problem definition and same domain. So you'll get the understanding how the application-based project, demo-based project are different from the research-based project. Then these are the instructions. So I was thinking that you all start preparing some video of present that contain problem definition that you are targeting. So video should contain application description about what application that you are dealing with, some demonstration that your application is showing, experimentation that your work being done for the particular problem and having solution, and then finding and good result that your work is being doing. So start thinking about how you can develop that video presentation of 20 minutes. So next, we'll have some video based presentation. So start developing that video of 20 minutes that have introduction, problem definition, solution definition, application description, demo, experimentation, finding and good result, whatever your group best suit to your group project. In the final project and assignment submission, there are three requirements that are essential. First is documentation that should be in PDF format, then slide, PPT or PDF. Third, video presentation that could be of 10 to 20 minutes. The most important thing, you should need to present slides in the video presentation with all team members. Suppose somebody have done work for a particular topic, then they should present that topic. So the presentation of each individual should be according to the contribution of the topic they have worked on. The next, the GitHub repository that you want to share or you don't want to share. If you share, then it's an advantage, add-on, bonus for your project. If you don't want to share, if you the Git repository or you don't want to share code, then it's fine. And we set the deadline for submission of these things at 14th November. So please try to submit all the assignment, both the assignment, that is, first is presentation, and second assignment documentation, and then you also need to submit
a video presentation. If possible, then code repository link. Try to do it before 14th November. All the best for all of you for the project and assignment submission.